So last week, we had a guest on the show, and it was a return guest named Nick. Nick had a topic he wanted to bring to the forefront, and it was called My Pet Peeves. You know what it was about. Dr. E hasn't had a chance to fill in on his part, and it was all about cell phones. It was all about people using their phones, not paying attention. We're curious to know, what is Dr. E's pet peeves? Have faith, let it begin. Monday edition starts right now.
Have faith, let it begin. When it starts right now.
Welcome to Have Faith. Let it begin. Here's your host, Angel Santana.
Ariel, can you say have faith?
Let it begin.
Let it begin?
Let it begin.
Say have faith.
Let it
begin.
No,
no. No? No? Okay.
It's a boy.
Hi, Noah.
Noah!
Noah.
Oh, Jesus. Happy birthday, Noah.
Caitlin.
You did
amazing.
Noah. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it
shine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it
shine.
This little light of
mine,
I'm gonna let it
shine.
Let it
shine.
Let it
say.
Let it
say.
Yeah.
Good morning. You're listening to Have Faith, Let Begin, and it starts right now. How was that, Daddy?
It was good. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Have Faith, Let It Begin. Welcome to another Monday edition as Dr. E is back with us. Dr. E, how are you, my friend?
Hello, Angel Santana. Have Faith, Let It Begin. How are my all my friends on the Have Faith Nation station? What's going on, everybody?
You know, it's been a long week. It feels almost like summer has already started and is already like halfway done, even though we haven't started. But I will say this, you know, having all these guests that are coming on, Nick has been on. You're the primary Monday co-host with me. We've got Eloise coming on in the next couple of weeks. I am just curious, as you heard all about the pet peeves, does Dr. E, A, have a pet peeve? And B, what do you think about the whole cell phone pet peeve that Nick brought to us?
Yeah, I think that the cell phone is a pet peeve. I know that I really set very, very strict boundaries with my kids as it related to their cell phones, especially at dinner or at meals. And if anybody got caught with their cell phone sneaking a peek, heads were going to roll and cell phones were going to be taken away and tears were going to be shed for sure. Definitely a problem. Dangerous. You know, walking through the hallways of the hospital, it's almost like being on a freeway. And, you know, these young residents, and I get it that they're getting, you know, it's not like they're looking up their horoscope. I mean, I'm sure somebody's sending them work to do or go see a patient here or go check this lab value there. But at the same time, not very safe. They're running into people and it's just not a good thing. Dangerous on the road. People are, even people that have those Apple Plays in their car still get distracted. So yeah, cell phones, a mixed bag. I don't know. I think people say, how did we ever live without them? Well, guess what? We did. We lived without them. Life was much simpler and life was arguably much better.
Yeah, I agree. And I think that what we did was we also, and great, great points there. I think what we did was we honed in on when we were at work, we find that as you are in the hallway, and like you said, doctors maybe going to a patient and they're trying to get all the information before they get to the patient. But you know, what I've noticed is that interaction, that communication that we once had, even in the stores with total strangers, usually when you make eye contact with somebody, you kind of give them a little nod and, you know, a nice smile. It doesn't happen anymore. It's not the same. And he gave a great example of a couple that were at dinner and throughout the entire dinner and the entire couple, I mean, I actually used the couple one. He said it was a wedding, a huge family. Nobody made eye contact except with the phones. It was not even a conversation.
Yeah, that's why I said no way. And actually, it's kind of funny. When I have a dinner with other kids, and when I say kids are now 30 years old, right? So my nieces and whatever, I took my niece out to dinner with my wife We were down in the city where she was going to college, and we went to a very nice, we took her to a very nice restaurant, and the first thing she did was take out our phone, and we basically said, sweetie, no phones at dinner. I think she looked at us like we had three heads on. You know, she just didn't get it. And it really is, it is a problem. It's a communication issue. You take the cell phones, you take social media, and you take COVID, and 25 years from now, when these young people are of age, you know, to start running the country and running things, I think we're going to have a problem.
Yeah. And it's funny. I never thought I'd ever use the term when I was your age, and I've used that a lot recently, but it is what it is. We're moving on to a different era. But the key factor is what you said. There's three big points. And those points are, if you're driving, let's stick to driving. If you are, you know, in a rush, try to keep your eye on what you're doing and not on the screen. And last, it's okay to put it down for a little while, just to see how the other half of or your family or your parents are. Because listen, we're not two guys here complaining about technology. Technology has its pros, but there's a lot of cons with that technology.
Yeah. And I know that even when I try to, you know, if we're doing our podcast and I'm going to be a few minutes late and I text you and you don't answer, you know, my first instinct is like this cultural, like, where the heck is Angel Santana? But then when I think about it, I say, good for Angel. He's probably giving the kids a bath. He's probably, you know, making the kids a grilled cheese sandwich. He's probably, you know, playing a game with, you know, with Noah, or reading a book to Ariel, or having Ariel read a book to him. And I say, you know what? God bless you. I'm glad that you're off your phone. My son actually has days where he goes completely offline. And I think that's terrific. So sometimes you'll text my kid and he won't get back to you till the next day. So I think we need to see more of that.
Absolutely. So we close out today's episode. We have to remember.
Angel, I have one more pet. I have one.
Oh,
more
you have a pet peeve. Go ahead.
Yeah. I mean, listen, is Nick taking off? Is Nick like starting to like take over the Monday slot? I mean, you know, do I need to worry?
No, Nick was on for Friday. So,
okay. So, you know, is he your new Friday guy?
He's become our new regular. So
Fridays are actually a better, you know, as far as the Nielsen ratings, there's higher ratings on Friday than on Monday, by the way. Okay. Back to my pet peeve. So I do have a pet peeve. It's complainers, people who complain. And there are two specific complainers that I can't stand. So I remember being on a lacrosse field or a soccer field a million trillion years ago when the dinosaurs were roaming the earth and my son was playing soccer with a rock, right? Because they didn't have balls back then. I mentioned to one of the fathers, oh man, another great Saturday on the field, you know, making a sarcastic remark. And he said, you know, I'm really happy to be here. And these times are not going to last long. And I see it a different way. And I, you know, kind of stopped and thought about that because, boy, what a way to school me, right? Just shut me right up. And I thought about it and I said, well, what he's really saying to me is, you know, he's really enjoying fatherhood and he's really enjoying every freaking second of it. And yeah, are kids a pain? Do they throw up? Do they spike fevers? Do they scare the living crap out of you? Do they like, you know, fall down and bleed and break bones and spend nights in the emergency room and, you know, wake up with a barky cough and, you know, and just have tantrums and drive you crazy? Of course they do. But you know what, for the parents out there, don't ever let the universe ever hear you complain, because there's a lot of people out there who want kids or have lost kids. And that's my first pet peeve. And my second pet peeve is a little closer to home as it relates to my professional life. I absolutely hate when I hear my colleagues complain about, you know, being a doctor or how they would never recommend being a doctor to their kids or any of that type of thing. And, you know, that drives me crazy because to sort of take a page from the Croc podcast, when we rail about the system and about the broken system, Man, you know what? If you became a doctor to make money, if you became a doctor for the power, the prestige, if you became a doctor for any reason other than to help people, and if you became a doctor and you think that you have a 9-to-5 job, or if you became a doctor and you think that being woken up in the middle of the night is something that's a pain in the neck, or if a patient is difficult, or if you just, you know, are exhausted or whatever, that's another pet peeve. Because you know what, being a doctor is an absolute, it's not only a privilege and honor, it's basically a message from God, you know, to serve your fellow brothers and sisters. So those are my two pet peeves, in addition to my competing co-host, Nick, his pet peeve about text messaging and cell phones.
And, you know, I said it on last week's episode, and I meant it. You know, we are prisoners of technology and of our phones. That's why they're called cell phones. So, you know, we'll leave it at that. And remember that each and every day is not promised. Every single day is a moment that we should cherish. Every second that we have with our family, with our friends, even with our colleagues, is something that we really need to take it all in, because we're not promised tomorrow. So as you go about your weekday and your Monday, which a lot of people tend to complain about Mondays, remember that Monday truly is just another day. Yeah, it's 4 days away from Friday. Maybe you are not, you know, maybe you're not happy with the way the beginning of the week starts. However, if you're waking up in the morning, that is a blessing. If you're in your car driving to work, W-O-R-K, that is a blessing. If you're able to buy and put food on tables and have a roof over your head, that is a blessing. But it all starts with one person, the person who created us in his image. And he is setting a table for us when we are ready to come home. May God be with you. May he shine his light upon you and grant each and every single one of you peace on earth. And never forget.
Have faith. Let it begin. Have a great, great week, everybody.
Take care.
Thank you for listening to Have Faith, Let It Begin. We'll be back tomorrow.
Thank you for listening to another episode of Have Faith, Let It Begin. That's right, Ariel. We're done with another show. And it's always great to have this show with you, my love. You know, we're going to encourage each and every person to listen to our show every single weekday. That's right. You and I are going to help change the world. Do you think that you can do that for me? Huh? Yeah, you know you can. She does. We want to let you know, and yes, we encourage you to listen to our show each and every weekday, and it's going to be live at 7:30. Make sure you're subscribed to our show. Make sure you get ready, fasten those seatbelts, because Ariel and I and my family are going to bring you a new topic, a new story, each and every day, right? Isn't that right, Ariel? Yeah. And we she's smiling at me. Guys, enjoy your day.
Thank you for listening to Have Faith, Let It Begin. We'll be back tomorrow.